Hello everyone and welcome to Settlement and Survival. We're back here instead of the mega build because my ambition got a little bit too big for my britches, and so I decided to punt and we're just going to go ahead and start on Spectacle. Since Spectacle Island was the third place finisher in the 1,000 subscriber request list, we're going to start on this thing today. This might be a little bit different because I've never really built Spectacle very much, and I tend to build small, and as you can see from this humongous build area. Oh my god, that green line goes all the way around the island. Ah, it's so much space. So I scouted this out. As you can tell, I built my little platform here. So what I'm going to do here, I think, is we're going to build ourselves a little village of sorts, a little fishing village, not really a vacation area. But I do want to barnacle off of that radio tower there. I want to incorporate that somehow. You can see my bed and stuff over there that I've got placed. I also reset the size bar mostly with gamma guns. It turns out it takes like 120 gamma guns to do this because Spectacle Island, of course, is huge. I have not scrapped this. I've looted it, but I have not really done a lot of tearing down yet because I didn't know what I wanted to do with it. And after the Somerville build, of course, I definitely enjoy incorporating the trees. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to build a little thing along this ridge right here. You can see where it drops off. And then put maybe a little farm in that little divot area there. And maybe build down to the beach and have, I don't know, a dock or whatever. Now, of course, I don't have mods on this. Settlement building mods, so I don't have boats and stuff like that. But we're going to see what we can do with this thing. And one other thing I'm going to do with this is part of the reason it's taking so long to do this. What I want to do is a lot of people, well, not a lot of people, enough. The question comes up fairly frequently. Is, you know, what inspires me, what influences do I have, and, you know, how do I get the scrappy look that I get, you know, because that's really all I do is I build scrappy. I don't build all pristine and fancy and detailed and complicated. I build scrappy. I like, you know, shacks and stuff. So I got a wild hair and I did some research to try and demonstrate what that means. And so what I'm going to try and do in this video is after I scout this out, I'm going to cut to an explanation of the first structure I'm going to put up here, which is going to be the player house, because I need to have my, you know, my base, because I'm in survival and I don't have any settlers here, nothing yet. And we'll go from there. So let's do the scouting first. So the intended area here is up here will be, you know, some houses or stuff on this little ridge, right? Because you can see how the hill goes down here. So if the hill goes down here, we can build crops, you know, right in here. We can make this the field. Let's just scrap that. I'm gonna get rid of that anyway. Build it out to here. Maybe build like a gate or something down here, an entryway down here, right? And then fence off this top field, I guess, right here. Or put the gate here, you know? Maybe put a gate here between these trees, then have it go up the hill through the field, past the field. I don't know. But see, this is why I don't plan, because I can't think of this stuff right away. But you can see the ridge goes down to here, and there's a nice little like viewpoint here where something can go, an observation post, a guard tower, whatever. Because if you go down the back of the hill here, there's, you know, really nothing. And there's all these bushes back here. Can't really do much with these. So I'll just incorporate this and make a trash pile back here or something. I don't know. I really don't know how this is going to come out. And then it'll extend down here, where there's sort of this little ramp right here where it sort of goes down to the water. And of course, keep that, you know, restroom, take this fence out, and then like build something on the shore here, you know, a pier, some, I don't know what. These rocks might be a problem. I'm not quite sure what the hell, but I do like this little ridge right here that might have some possibilities as well. So this, I think, is where we're gonna get started. So I need a player house and I need it to barnacle off of this. So look at that. Even this little thing is so much huger than I usually build. So we may not get down to the water. I don't know. Or I'll just put, you know, disassociated buildings or something. So how do I want to build off this? I don't know. But you know what? Let's do this. Let me go up here and prepare this for an eventual cut to an explanation of the first building I have chosen to, whoops, duplicate. And then, I don't know. I guess we'll see what happens. So put it up here, focus on that tower so I can recreate this, and I will be back shortly. So our first example house is a Bethesda house, and here it is. This particular house is located just by South Boston High School. There's a couple of them here surrounded by a fence and stuff like that, kind of near the castle, so you know where this house is. So here's what a Raider house looks like. Now this thing, of course, uses extra mods, modded stuff like the chain link fence and that double thing there, but you can look and see how this is built, right? Here's your windowed thick wall and the base. They use a lot of those shack supports. I've noticed that a lot. They use a lot of shack supports. But again, this is something you've seen me build 1,000 times, right? With the little railings on the side of the thick wall. You know, here's your regular doorway with the stair, with, you know, with the ladder, the stairway ladder, whatever. And then, of course, more of those supports there. But you can see underneath that this is just a straight up shack foundation piece right here in the front that it's snapped to. So on the right, we've got our window with our two railings, which are the same, interestingly enough. And then that double wide slanted piece that we get in USO, that, you know, the one that dips that you can't do. But again, it's not quite joined up. You can see where it's sort of tilted there. And then you've got a railing there, and then the thrash wall piece. We've got you've got the rocket blanket roof there. And then we've got this other deep wall with another one of those side railings with the ladder in it, because you've seen me do that as well. Of course, that ladder's downsized. It's too narrow. But here's a junk wall right there. And there's another shack foundation tilted to the side there. And then here's another chain link fence. So there you go. There's your basic form factor for a house. And I mean, if you played the game, you've been through here probably 10, 15 times. And you know, you go through here, you fight the raiders, you loot the crap. But it's such a natural part of the environment, you don't think to really look at it. But it's really a very simple thing in its execution, right? So let's go ahead and fade out, and then I will go back to Spectacle Island. All right, so first order of business, now that we've got our template in our head, is to, well, I'm gonna go ahead and tear this thing down for parts because I can use these things. I probably should have scrapped the yellow things first, but hey, whatever, hindsight's 20/20. So it's theory time. I hope this is not boring. So why I examined that thing, that's how I learned to make my stuff blend, is to take something I saw in game, memorize it as best I could, right? Go somewhere, like I'm going here, and duplicating it as best I could from memory. It's like, okay, I remember that last thing is what? It's two shack floors and it's four window railing things, and then two roofs and a couple of ladders, right? So now we're gonna just go ahead and recreate that what we just saw as best we can, right? Because this will be the foundation, this will be the base for the structure that I'm going to eventually make out of it. Because the thing about Bethesda structures that you see in the game, right? They fit where they are perfectly because they're designed and built for where they're at, okay? As an example, that, like the house we're duplicating here, right? It had the window on the front of it, which faced the street, and it had an entrance on the back of it towards this little courtyard and yada, 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 whatever, with chain link fences and junk fences separating it because it was wedged between two buildings. Clearly, I do not have two buildings here to wedge this between, and I don't know how I'm going to do it, but what I want to do is I start with the actual thing that they have, because I know that form factor, that proportion, those pieces make it, quote, scrappy, okay? So here's a crappy analogy. I don't know, I'm not very good at analogies. I keep trying, hopefully this one will work. Doing this part right here when you're learning to build scrappy is like when you're learning a sport or learning to play an instrument, okay? Like you learn to play guitar, right? You learn scales, you learn fingering, you learn the basic fundamental parts of playing the instrument so that you can develop the, quote, muscle memory. Like hitting a tennis ball, you know, shooting a basketball, throwing a football, hitting a baseball, you know, pitching, catching. You pitch over and over and over and over and over and over, and you shoot baskets over and over and over until pretty soon you can automatically shoot a basket from anywhere because you don't need to think about your wrist and your fingers and your legs, and you just do it because you've built the muscle memory. Doing this, building their structures first, is what builds that, quote, muscle memory. Right? So in music terms, doing this is like the click when you play the drums. You know, you can learn paradiddles, flams, and fills, and whatever, but you're always on the click, 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 right? Because that way, no matter who plays with you, no matter what instrument they bring to the table, it's always going to be music. This is my click to build scrappy, is to duplicate what they've done. So here we go. I've got the basic building. I have not, I did not go back and review the video, by the way. I just basically try to remember it as I watched it, as I'm narrating it. So this is probably wrong. There's probably a couple pieces that are wrong. I've already substituted one because that little flat railing wouldn't fit next to the door, but the three slat one did. So now I'm looking, I'm like, okay, I need to put this thing up next to my radio tower, because this is, you know, this is the main house. This will be the keystone of the settlement. And of course I can't get it to go because it's too far away. Because of course, that's one of the dangers of building big houses and dropping them in, is that the distance you get with your anchor piece is pretty limited. So you gotta be creative about it. So now that I've got my basic house, right, I take it and I put it where I want it. And this requires fiddling because, again, I don't want to sit here and pick the thing up and put it down and slide it all around and get the elevation right. And I can't figure out why this is not going in. I have not figured out yet that my ladders, my stairways, are the long ones, not the short ones. So that's giving me all kinds of clipping problems down there in the front. But once I get the house in place, right, once I get the basic structure down, then what I do is I go back and I look at it and I modify it. I make it my own. Like here, I'm already doing it, right? Since it's going to face down the hill where I'm going to put the crops, I want the observation window and the door to face that way. So I need to switch those two pieces. So already I've modified this thing and sort of made it my own, right? At heart, it's still a scrappy Bethesda structure that exists somewhere in the game, but by the time we're done, I will own it because I will have put my style on it. And that's why this works so well for anyone who wants to learn how to build scrappy, because you have your own preferences, right? You have your own style, you have your things you like. And that's fine, that's great, that's awesome. That's what makes this whole building thing fantastic. But the beautiful part about it is it'll be consistent, because underneath, you'll have the click. You'll have Bethesda structure as your, quote, foundation, you know? I mean, yeah, you can keep modifying this until it's unrecognizable and, you know, like whatever, but even then, as a builder, you'll be learning all kinds of new techniques and new styles and new approaches to solving the problems that you want to solve with the building you're trying to create. And of course, I can't do that because I can't see the back of it. So now I got to slice from the front. So, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know if that's interesting or not. I hope it is, because I don't really think about this stuff. You know, I just build because I've been doing this for so long and I've already learned how to build the way I like, and in such a way that it blends that there's no conscious thought. It's just like, okay, I need this and this and this. I know the proportions, I know the ratios. Like even now, this thing here, I'm looking at it and I'm thinking that there's a lot of wood here. I need to be putting a little bit less, I need to use something else other than wood here. But I end up using, I think, a metal piece and some barn pieces later on. But yeah, now I gotta put my ladders back because I like to keep my tools all in one place so later on when I'm looking for them, I know where they're at. And yeah. So I don't even know what to talk about now. I guess I can just wing it. Another thing about the style here. So now I'm looking at it again, right? I've got it in place and I'm thinking, okay, how am I going to dress this thing out? Because I can't make it look like the other one. Its purpose is different than the one in the alley, right? It's different than the one we modeled this off of. So now we're going to go through and I'm going to think about what I want to do with it. How do I want this to fit? I'm thinking maybe I want to do this and I'll do an elevation. I'll put some stairways and make a different elevation. Doesn't work. That thing ain't going to come up. So now I'm just going to do what I'm going to do. Probably put another railing on here, right? Yeah, let's put the railings back. That little thing didn't work out. Another part of scrappy is experimentation, as you're seeing here. Try things, put things up. Maybe you'll like what it looks like. Try dumb stuff. Sometimes the dumbest stuff looks the coolest. You never know. But if you get stuck in a rut, then you'll find that your stuff starts looking a lot, it looks more samey. It looks too similar all the time. And then what you'll have is a non-scrappy settlement. You'll have much more of a plan looking settlement. Now that's what you're going for, fantastic. Then, you know, do it. Use the same pieces over and over and make it look, you know, standard or whatever. So now I'm thinking, okay, I need to patch these holes. How am I gonna do it? I don't have the pieces that Bethesda had. I don't have the shack foundation, so I have to do something a little bit different. What I'm going to do is this, is I'm going to put that little wall piece there as a sort of pseudo railing that also covers up the ground. That's an excellent example of good enough and not fussing too much about things that don't work. Like there with that particular piece, my concern was getting it right to have it the right, so it would fit in right and it'd be the right, about the right height. That's it. If it's not exactly right, I don't care. The reason I take so long to fiddle with it and get it right the first time is not that I want it to look perfect or look a certain way. I just don't want to have to redo it if I don't like it when I take out the pillar. That I'm just trying to save time. So here, now you're going to see another one of my go-to tricks. Sinking a junk wall as a support foundation through the thing. And we saw this in the Somerville thing where I sit inside the house and I, you know, line it up on the inside of the wall and push it down. The problem here is the rug is too far forward and I can't get it to sink, so now I have to move it. Unfortunately, in this particular application, that does not work. This is not going to work. Spoiler alert, this isn't going to work the way I want it to. I'm not going to be able to seat it from the inside because I can't tell how far it is on the outside corner from here. And because it's so exposed, because I have room on the outside, I really should be on the outside. You should only be on the inside when you don't have room on the outside, because you get very weird results. But here we go, sinking it in there. And the rest of this is basically going to be dressing this house up and turning it into something that's more mine rather than more Bethesda, if that makes any sense. I think it does. I think I may have explained that concept fairly well. But for the future of this particular series, this particular build, I'm basically going to build a settlement out of things I've seen in the Commonwealth. And the research I was talking about is I went on one of my older characters, actually my first character, the guy I made to blast through the game at release so I could avoid spoilers, right? So he just basically tore through the game as quickly as possible. And I found out some really interesting things about that particular playthrough. One is I've been playing survival for so long, right? And I have had the Brotherhood as my ally for so long that when I hear a vertibird, that is universally a good sign. Okay, that means friendlies are nearby. They're around, they're good. Okay, I'm great. But in my first playthrough, I went with, you know, the Minutemen because they were the convenient ones. They were the ones that it seemed like the game wanted me to use, right? So when I went through my old quest log, because I was looking, I couldn't unlock Boston Airport. I'm like, it won't unlock, why won't it unlock? Well, it turns out I never did the quest for, Initiate Clark. And apparently you need to clear the airport to unlock that without the Brotherhood. Well, the problem is those ghouls are under the airport and I can't get to them because I ain't got the key card, because he has the key card and everything's rubbled out because the quest never started. So I can't clear the airport. But when I did that, I was looking through my quest log trying to figure out why the hell I couldn't, you know, unlock this thing. And it turns out that I did almost nothing with the Brotherhood. I mean, I found Paladin Dance, I did Arc Jet, I did a quarter mastery mission for Halen and Reese. I did go to the Pridwin with Dance after I killed Kellogg. I did the tour of the Pridwin. I talked to Elder Maxon. I left, and then the next time I saw them, I killed them all. I mean, I literally didn't even do Fort Strong. I was so viscerally repulsed by Maxon on my first playthrough. He is such a lunatic fanatic. I was like, no, I can't do this. I'm not. Because I was like, oh, Preston's so nice, and oh, the Minutemen are so, it sucks that they're so, yeah, whatever. Now I know that they're, you know, a total stain on the Commonwealth, but whatever, that's my personal opinion. Anyway, so back to the vertebrate. So I'm playing this guy, and I'm down at Jamaica playing, and I'm farting around doing stuff, and I hear a vertebrate coming. I'm like, sweet. So I go outside, and it lights me up. And the guy in the minigun's like, brrr. I'm like, oh, that's right. They're not my friends here. And that was a little bit of an eye-opener. But anyway, I used him because he's the lowest level guy I got. He's like, I don't know, he's 83 now. And he can fast travel. He doesn't need to eat or sleep. And oh my God, that's so nice. He doesn't need to eat, he doesn't need to sleep, doesn't need to carry antibiotics. Ammo doesn't weigh anything. I'm like, oh, this is delicious, man. I got 470 pounds of stuff I can grab. This is awesome. But on the other side of the coin, he's playing normal mode, so he doesn't have legendaries for crap. He doesn't have mods, so there's bugs everywhere. I had forgotten how bad the bugs are in the Pip-Boy settlement readout things until I started playing them again. Man, it zeroes out all the time. It bugs like crazy without the patch. So I was really missing the unofficial Fallout patch. But basically what I did is I went around to every settlement and raider camp and other settler camp I could remember off the top of my head. And I made a bunch of individual videos where I basically just turned the recorder and walked around examining various pieces and structures and the stuff like that. And you'll be seeing some of those depending on, you know, who goes where, depending on what I need in which position. and stuff like that. So this, but you, at this point, what you're watching is me dressing this thing up, patching the holes, hiding it based on my techniques, which is, you know, sinking railings and stuff up, and we're done. Looks like we're gonna be done here. Look at that. So here's what we've got. Now you remember the first building, you can rewind and look at the first building. Here's what it looks like now. This is a Bethesda building, but it's also mine, and it's scrappy. It's got, you know, it's my signature style with the sunkenness and the mixed back materials and the sunken little railing and no chain link fences and stuff like that. But here you go. This is one example of how you can build scrappy in your style while still making it look like it belongs in the game, because it sort of did come from the game. Yeah, so here's our first building. Probably gonna dress this up a little bit more. I don't like that little gap at the bottom. And you know, we'll have to put my bed and my furniture in here and, you know, decorate it, furnish it. But for now, we're just gonna leave the shell, because this is gonna be our template for the style for the rest of the plays. Because the settlers here obviously are all gonna build pretty much the same, right? Because they're the same settlers, at least in theory. We'll see how it goes. Who knows how it's gonna go? I keep looking at this vast expanse. I don't know what the hell I'm gonna do with it. Oh God, help me, what have I done? But anywho, so there we go. Let's go up on our little platform and then we'll do our little sign off. And I hope this is interesting. If you got any questions, leave them in the comments, or, you know, comments or observations, suggestions. I mean, I'm just winging it here. So here it is. And I want to thank you all very much for subscribing and watching. And I will see you in the next one. Take care.